Interesting story here about privatization of the 9/11 dispatch services in New Jersey. One town is doing it. Lawrence in Mercer County became the first New Jersey municipality to make the move in 2013. And the town said that they will probably see cost savings over the time. But the main reason for the switch was that it would get more officers on the street, because officers would fill in any time the regular operator was out or indisposed, and it was taking up too much of the officers' time. But the privatization, is, they say, is certainly doing its job, and other towns are considering that. Of course, a lot of towns would not touch it. But the very act of privatizing government services, there is a catch-22 in that. And we've seen that happen with the, DMV, it was known as in its day, the Motor Vehicle Commission, Department of Motor Vehicles. That was privatized back during the Whitman's administration and rather quickly unprivatized it, not too long after. And Easy Pass. You could see, automobile inspection, when this goes way back, when they turned it over to the Parsons Company. That was one of the big fiascos of our time when they first took that over. And they got this. See, now that's the catch-22. You can privatize these government functions, but what happens is politics gets involved in it, and the contracts are given out for political purposes, largely in return for political contributions. Parsons Company got the original inspection contract because they gave $286,000 to the Republican Party in New Jersey and promised some huge paying jobs to a lot of Governor Whitman's cronies, which they eventually did give the jobs, and they got the contract. And this was so rigged that they were the only bidder because they had cooked the request for proposals so that only that one company could meet the qualifications, the standards of it. And so this happens. Easy Pass, you remember. Every other state had Easy Pass working swimmingly, except New Jersey. It was a mess. So that got cleaned up during the McGreevy administration. And the Whitman administration had given the contract out to a company that would no wise could have handled it, but boy, could they contribute. So we have all of these examples now. The motor vehicle agencies, remember, that was privatized. That sounds good. Normally, yeah, private company is going to be much more efficient than the government, except who gets the contract from the government? It's the political crony. Generally, these people end up being often spectacularly unqualified to handle it. So there's a problem with that. So be very careful when you're tempted with privatization. It really sounds good. But remember, who is going to pick the private organization?